Hello, Professor Miller. What are we going to talk about today?
Hello, Ivan. Today we will talk about digital twins. Okay, there is no clear definition of a digital twins or worldwide accepted one. Basically, it is used in many domains and everybody is giving his own definition, or it's used also a bit like a buzzword. Mm-hmm. I will explain what digital twins means for us. For us, it is a digital replica of our physical environment, our physical world, like the city with the buildings, the trees, the vegetation, with the roads and all around them.
Okay. And why do we need such a thing?
It can be useful for many applications. With one sentence, I can answer that it can solve many societal challenges and societal problems, especially when we talk about some strong geo-visualization and geospatial component involved. For example, in the urban planning domain, up to now, the 3D city models have been created quite in a static way. The synchronization between different departments in a municipality or ministries is pretty much lacking in many countries. So with digital twins, we are trying to do one step further than the static 3D city models that we have been working up to now. We try to integrate more different types of data to synchronize the models, to make them more dynamic, because the cities are changing every day, and we try mm-hmm. to update and, or at least to develop algorithms that can update them and keep them up to date, and to of course share them in a more easy, user-friendly way with the users and the stakeholders.
Okay, so if I understand correctly, there are two things there. One is that there's the interaction part, so let's say everybody, all the stakeholders use the same data or the same 3D map. And the other one is that the map keeps on changing, so there is the dynamicity on.
Yes, yes, and also you can, having a digital replica of the city or neighborhood or a building, you can represent its history, you can represent its current situation, but also it's very powerful for creating scenarios for future predictions, for example, for emergency responses. Or you also asked me about why do we need it. Some of the applications that I can mention are, for example, related with climate change, with energy efficiency, with flood simulation or other disaster simulation, or even mainly for urban planning challenges. Nowadays, cities are growing so much. We are living in urban environment more and more, and the land is limited. So the vertical dimension is growing, and therefore we need to visualize them in 3D. So having that in mind, synchronized digital twins can be very useful.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. And if I want to build a digital twin, what are the tools that I need?
There are many methods, there are many approaches that you can apply for such a problem or such a task. Working in the Faculty of Earth Observation and Geoinformation, of course you can guess that we are working with such type of data. So our starting point is what sensors are available for the area that we are planning to build the model. We start from searching of available satellite images or aerial acquisition data from airplane or UAVs, unmanned aerial vehicles, or nowadays famous as drones. This can be an image data source, but we can also have a point cloud data source from LiDAR acquisition or terrestrial LiDAR scanning. And having already the data ready, we have to think what kind of processes we can run on that data. Can we use automation, like for example machine learning or deep learning algorithms, to speed up extracting some features or objects out of this data? Mm-hmm. Can we use some maps existing on the area? Or also we can combine our domain with civil engineers, which are working on building information modeling. We call those intelligent models that are very detailed and can complement with more, let's say, detailed information, which is beneficial for these digital twins. Also, as you can imagine, we are trying to speed up the processing, like using cloud computing, using open source solutions to develop the digital twins and to share them in a more easy way with the stakeholders. Would be nice if we can also involve them in the creation, and also it would be easy afterwards for them to update themselves and maintain these models.
Okay. So from what I understand, the scale right now that we look into is cities or neighborhoods. Can we ever have a world digital twin that encompassing the whole Earth?
Yeah, we can have. Our domain and our work here is more on building or city or neighborhood scale, but you can have. But the difference is the level of details that you would like to visualize. On the world, we can visualize everything a little bit more generalized. Of course, depending on what you want to do with your 3D city model, a 3D model of the Earth. And when we focus on the scale of cities or buildings, we go more into details. Mm-hmm. And everything depends on the purpose. Everything depends on the aim of the project or the model that you would like to do.
Okay. Can you give an example of a digital twin that you have used?
Yes. Since I'm more in the urban planning and land administration department, our application focus is much more stronger. So we were trying to use and combine innovative methods. For example, for assessing the solar potential energy, for 3D valuation, property valuation. We have students working on that, so to monitor the variety of property prices in terms of 3D. We have...
Meaning that an apartment on the ground floor costs more or less than the apartment on the...
There are countries where there is no much difference between which floor are you really living, and mm-hmm. The prices are pretty the same. But it matters. You can have shadows that can cover your property. So we have shadow analysis, visibility analysis that we have been doing for these particular tasks. Also, we have been working a bit also of the combination between overground and underground and integration of such type of data into a synchronized model for municipalities. There was a project also on involving citizens in the decision-making process of in urban planning. So when there is a new area that has to be planned, they can also contribute with their ideas. Mm-hmm. Also, efficiency in urban planning in terms of where the schools will be located, where the health facilities could be located. So now we are working on a parametric modeling for walkability analysis, for example. Last year we had a student on green facades focusing on urban Hate Island. So there are a lot of applications that we are working on here.
Oh, wonderful. Yeah. Oh, thank you very much for this interview. Yeah.
Thank you very much, Ivan. It was a pleasure.
Do you want to be a GeoHero as well? Then take the first step and click the subscribe button and then the bell button to always be the first to know when one of our GeoHeroes posts a new video.